When Apollo, Jahvi's son, had finished his labor in the dawn of Dan, the god of earth and her heavens foresaw that his own resurrection, and his people with him, had come. So he sent his proper officers to the libraries of Atmospheria, to learn who of all the Aetherian hosts should be selected to remain as god, and who as lords, for the next 400 years. In 20 days the examiners returned and came before the throne of God and the council of Gao. Zdukawaski, chief speaker, said, "By the grace of Jahvi, creator, we stand before you, god of heaven and earth. We find by the ancient precepts, yes, by the ancient principles regarding our path of action, which are adjudged wise in the foundation of Atmospheria, one Gur, highest and most proficient of all the hosts of heaven, to be anointed god for the next 400 years." The soon-to-be resurrected god said, "I remember Gur, from Majul, in Suftus, in Aetheria, god of Rayaduf and Agi, 72. Let the marshals go to him and acquaint him with Jahvi's decrees, in the name of God. And they shall provide suitable conveyance for Gur to come to Gao, according to his rate." So the marshals, 10,000 in number, besides 10,000 musicians, went and brought Gur before the throne of God, coming in an ottoman prepared for the purpose, and adorned with 1,000 pillars of light. The soon-to-be resurrected God said, "I salute you, O Gur, in the name of Jahvi, creator. Behold Apollo." Apollo stretched forth his hand, and Gur came and shook hands with him, standing by the throne. Gur said, "That I have lived to see this day, O Jahvi, I am blessed indeed. Your will, O God, and Jahvi's, be done." The soon-to-be resurrected God said, "Behold, within 30 days the dawn of Dan is to end, and all who choose, and are prepared for the third resurrection, shall be taken up to Aetheria. Besides yourself, O Gur, there are 200,000 Aetherians who have volunteered to remain another 400 years in these Atmospherian heavens, and on the earth. From them you shall select 10,000 lords, and bestow them with kingdoms over mortals. And I, the soon-to-be resurrected god of earth and her heavens, will raise 2 billion angels up with me to Aetheria. And to you, O Gur, I, the soon-to-be resurrected god of earth and her heavens, bequeath 2 billion Atmospherians who have been initiated into the second resurrection. And of the first resurrection, 250 million, and of fetals 300 million, and besides these, the inhabitants of the earth, men, women and children, 700 million. The soon-to-be resurrected god ceased speaking, and Gur said, "Your will be done, O Jahvi." Then the Asinors sang, and the trumpeters played the march of Apollo, Jahvi's son. Presently, the marshals and messengers filed before the throne, and a light of golden fire came down from Aetheria, cast out by the gods of Halmatia, Orion Arc of Tanaya. And it, the light of golden fire, fell upon the throne of God, and many could not look upon it because of the brilliancy. The soon-to-be resurrected God raised up, as did Apollo by his side. And God said, "I stretch forth my hand to you, O Jahvi. Behold your son, Gur, god of Rayaduf, in Aetheria, an earth-born, 40,000 years inhabitant of your emancipated realms. By your power, and in your name, O Jahvi, I proclaim him god of heaven and earth, to bestow you and your kingdoms on angels and men. Be with him, O Father, Creator, that he may add to your glory forever. Amen." The soon-to-be resurrected god, now stepping down, took off the triangle. The royal heirloom passed on from one god of heaven and earth to the next, and hung it on Gur's, the newest god's, neck, saying, "I now bestow you, Gur, with the heirloom of the gods of the Red Star, the triangle of the ancients. And so that you may be still further honored, behold, one higher than I, even Apollo, shall weave a crown for your head." Apollo walked to the left-hand side, and raised his hand upward, and from unseen space a flame of yellow light came to rest on his hand, and he turned it, the flame of yellow light, just half around, and lo, A crown with sparkling gems stood upon his fingers and Apollo had said, incomprehensible all light, my Jahavi. Weave me, Apollo, a crown for your son, Ger, god of heaven and earth. And even while he, Apollo, spoke it, the request was done, and he placed it, the newly fashioned crown, on God's, which is to say, Ger's head. And God Ger went and sat in the middle of the throne, saying, throne of your throne, O Jahavi. All things are yours. For this shall be my resting place, to do your will. During the ceremonies, the music was timed accordingly, and when the new god, Ger, was crowned, the multitude of a billion applauded with great joy. When all was quiet, God Ger rose up from the throne, saying to Apollo, and to him who had been God, in Jahavi's name, come and honor my throne. Accordingly, they both sat down at the right-hand side of God. God Ger said, in 30 days, the dawn of Dan will end. Let the marshals, through the messengers, proclaim the resurrection of 2 billion to the Aetherian heavens on that day. Proclaim it in all the heavens of the earth, inviting all to come who can, for it shall be a day of the feast of glory. But do not tell any of these, that there has been a change of gods, nor that great Apollo will rise also, lest sorrow come upon the people. The marshals then selected messengers, a great number, and sent them throughout the heavens of the earth, proclaiming the commandments of God. God Ger spoke further, saying, for 30 days the council shall deliberate on my 10,000 lords, selecting and allotting them, and I will crown them in the name of the Father. Apollo then said, now I will clothe myself in strange colors, so no one shall recognize me, and during the 30 days I yet remain, I will go about over the earth, so that I may again look upon the star of my birth, upon this earth of my beginning. And he who had given up the throne as God of heaven and earth said, your joy, Apollo, shall be my joy also. I too, will again visit the star of my birth, this earth of my beginning. Accordingly, God Ger said, joy to you both, in Jahavi's name. Behold, I, Ger, will throw a thick blanket over the throne, and you Apollo and my soon-to-be resurrected God shall change your attire, and when I withdraw it, you too shall walk forth unknown. And this change in attire was done.